Charabha is an avatar of Lord Shiva, which is not commonly known. This is considered as the most powerful appearance taken by Shiva to protect the universe. His manifestation as Sarbeshwara was to dominate over the fierce embodiment of Lord Vishnu as Narasimha. The objective of Vishnu's incarnation was to save his favorite devotee prince Prahlada from the demon king Hiranyakashipu, who was his father. After killing him, Narasimha seemed to be very furious in nature. He created an awful situation in the universe by roaring dreadfully and continuously. By foreseeing the negative outcome of this, other gods and sub-gods sought help from Mahadev, who then decided to take the Charabha form to pacify the angry Narasimha and convert him to normal Vishnu. The Charabha form of Shiva was a structural blend of human, animal and bird with gigantic as well as blistering look. It had so many hands, claws and legs and almost resembled a huge dragon. The entangled tresses in the body highlighted the ferocity of nature to a greater extent. In the head there was a massive crest which looked like a dome. There were well-spread wings on the backside of body with a long tail. The extremely sharp incisors in the mouth and inflexible claws were its main weapons. Its thunder-like voice created echo in the environments and was horrible to hear. It had three eyes which were glowing like fireballs. Its teeth and lips were well-formed and can only be seen properly. It produced awful hissing sounds throughout. Narasimha is often visualized as having a human torso and a lower body with lion face and claws. This image is widely worshipped in deity form by a significant number of Vaishnava groups. So, how did Lord Narasimha die? After the destruction, Prahlada, Lakshmi and various demigods attempted to soothe the Lord's anger, but without success. At first, Lord Shiva took the form of Virabhadra and asked Narasimha to cool down, but Narasimha ignored his appeal. So he himself transformed to colossal Charabha, which outclassed the Narasimha form. Then Charabha lifted Narasimha with its long tail and was about to throw him. Narasimha realized this and prayed Charabha to forgive him with beautiful epithets, which later became the Ashtotra. 108 Names of the Victorious Lord. Lord Shiva ensured the recovery of Lord Vishnu from his ferocious nature and hence did not hurt him. As a mark of respect to Lord Shiva, Narasimha removed the skin of lion from his body and presented it to Sarbeshwara Murti. Thus, the incarnation as Charabha by Lord Shiva pacified the Narasimha manifestation of Lord Vishnu. The extension story is that after defeating Lord Narasimha, Lord Charabha couldn't relieve of his extraordinary ferocity and started wreaking havoc more than Lord Narasimha did after killing Hiranyakashipu. To stop him, Lord Vishnu takes another form called Gandhabherunda. After an 18-day ferocious battle between both avatars, the battle seemed never-ending. So Ma Adishakti took her form of Devi Pratyanigra and explained each of the avatars their essences and how Lord Shiva and Lord Vishnu are united. This story wasn't there in the Puranas and was termed to be interpolated. It is not that Lord Shiva and Lord Vishnu are different. Harihara are the united power of the universe. Sometimes it is Lord Vishnu who would stop Lord Shiva, and sometimes it is Lord Shiva who needs to stop Lord Vishnu. Together they maintain the harmony of the universe.